This was sent to CornyDriveThru at gmail.com from Ed Green. I'd like to know your thoughts on WWE purchasing Evolve Wrestling. I know that they've had a working relationship the last few years, but do you think this will have a ripple effect on other indie promotions? Is there a possibility, with WWE now owning Evolve's library, could Vince be opening himself up to lawsuits if wrestlers like the Young Bucks don't give their consent to show their likenesses on the network? Also,
I'd love to see that one.
Also, where do you think the acquisition will leave Gabe Sapolsky?
Well, multi-part question there. We talked about it a week or so ago. I said I wouldn't be surprised to see Gabe end up working with NXT somehow, because that's what he has done well and liked to do for the last, 15 years or however long, is work with young talent. And the, you know, we talked about the style that he books best is the real niche independent style. It's not a mainstream style, but it's where a lot of those guys get started. And since they have plucked some of his talent, I think they probably, and worked with him, I think they would probably not have a problem with Gabe having a part in their training program, since loosely that's what he's been doing. So that's what Gabe might be doing. As far as buying Evolve, I'm sure they bought the tape library because some of their guys have come from there. I'm pretty doggone sure they're not going to run Evolve as a wrestling promotion. Am I mistaken there? Has somebody said something?
I have not heard anything about that.
Yeah, no, what they're doing is they're buying the trademark and the intellectual property and the tapes. And I would venture to guess that, except I don't know the entire Evolve roster from scratch and what they have on tape, but I would say, besides if somebody is really hot in the WWE at this point in time, it's going to be a while before anybody ever sees that stuff, if they ever do. They've got 200 hours of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. They put up like 12 that featured Storm and Jericho. They've got tons of stuff there. They just want to own it. And if one of those kids or guys that they've gotten from Evolve does make it big, then they've got tape that they can capitalize on. A lot of it's probably never going to be seen, because I'm sure also it'll be used in my God, the Smoky Mountain Wrestling stuff, where we had, you know, tape of these guys in buildings in front of thousands of people in arenas like Knoxville Coliseum, whatever. They still use it like a, you know, back when, and the old smoke-filled arena, and, you know, happier days when they were trying and struggling type of thing. So what's it going to look like when they've got 100 people in a, you know, in a fucking nightclub? They
don't even use the OVW footage, really.
Well, yeah, only in, you know, hey, here's Cena, and they've just now started with the Ruthless Aggression era, where they use a few more clips, but no, they don't. It's only basically for documentaries. You could have the greatest match in the world, but if it's from a territory or from a low-budget atmosphere, they're not going to fucking feature that on any, you know, except for clips and in telling the story of this talent that went wherever. So they bought the library, probably wanted to help Gabe out, have that now if they need it. I'm sure if Gabe's interested, I'm sure they'd probably be interested in speaking about something for him to do with NXT. But the Evolve is done as an active promotion, I would be pretty sure. Because why would they? They're already running NXT. Why would they want to run Evolve on top of that?
Well, beyond being a booker, I think if you look at Gabe Sapolsky in Ring of Honor and in Evolve, you could argue that he's been a really successful talent scout. He's found a lot of guys before WWE or AEW, obviously, or Impact or anyone else knew about them. And do you think this affects that? Does this affect his ability to discover new talent?
I don't think it affects his ability to discover new talent. I think whether they give him a job to do that or not affects his inclination to go out and discover new talent. Right now, he would just be doing it as a hobby. What's he going to go around to shows around the country and say, oh boy, that guy'd be great. If I had a company, I'd fucking, you know, book him. I'll write his name down. No, but if they want to pay him to go around and do that, I bet you he could find some.
It is amazing the amount of guys that he booked in Ring of Honor and Evolved that you wouldn't think when you saw them, like, these guys are WWE wrestlers, not because they weren't good, but just because they maybe weren't big enough, or they were wrestling in indie style, and almost all those big stars, the stars that he promoted as big stars in Ring of Honor, let's say, almost all of them, CM Punk, Bryan Danielson, Samoa Joe, all those guys ended up working for the WWE.
Well, and, you know, and then some of the guys that he swore off ever booking again, low-key, it's the exact opposite. He wanted guys that were coachable, that were smart, but were dedicated, not, you know, problem children, that if you critiqued them, they would want to do better. Samoa Joe, Chris Hero, CM Punk, Bryan Danielson, all those guys you mentioned, Nigel McGuinness, all those guys fit into that kind of category. And that's why they succeeded not only in Ring of Honor, wherever Gabe was, but, you know, when they went elsewhere, because they had those qualities. And, but you can tell it when you're the booker of a small company, you can tell a lot about who you'd want to book again and who you wouldn't, based on how much of a fucking pain in the ass they are to you when they're not even making any money. Because if a guy's a pain in the ass to you when nobody's really making any money, when somebody starts making money, he's going to be a bigger pain in the fucking ass.